Thank you all for tuning into the Bell Family Hour, brought to you by Bell Cooking Products.
Every little lady has a secret dream, things to make her house just gleam, things to make her meals the best. Bell's cooking products meet the test. In the kitchen, think of Bell's.
Yes, for the finest in cooking products, think of Bell's. And now for our story of the week. The universe is filled with forces. Forces that swirl around us, dragging us along on its winding, unpredictable course. Some are seen, and others are unseen. Some call it fate. Some call it the hand of God. Others just shrug and say, it's all just the luck of the dice. And this is not only true for us humans, it is also true for cats. So what unforeseen events can arise when these forces bring a person from rural China and a six-toed orange cat together in Bergen County, New Jersey? This is what the story of Bin and the six-toed orange cat is all about. And now, let's meet the players in our story.
Hi, I am Bobo. At least that's what the Zhu family calls me. I have lived in many households with many silly names over the years. But so far, the Zhu family have been my best servants. Now, everyone knows that cats have five toes. But I have six toes, so my paws look more like catcher's mitts than regular cat's paws. When an ordinary cat sees my paws, they know I'm special. Why am I special? I am special because I have a destiny. I am Bobo, the cat the fates chose to be the owner of the Zhu family.
Hi, I am Bin, Bin Zhu. I born to very poor parents in Yicheng, small city along Yangtze River in China. I have 11 siblings, all of them smart, all go to prestigious schools and graduate with honors. Some become doctors, some high-ranking officers in Chinese military, some university professors. All Zhu's very smart. When I in school in China, I had to deal with bullies. I am not big. In fact, when I young, I really small, skinny kid. Because I am smart, like all Jews, I am good in school. Soon the local bullies find out I can help them with schoolwork, which I do. Because I help them, they protect me. I am made man. I win scholarship to Tsinghua University, top engineering school in China. Then I come to America for a PhD.
Hi, I'm Mike. As a kid, it was said that I was somewhat mischievous. Yeah, I was creative and had a knack for figuring things out, which is why I became an engineer and eventually started my own company, which is how I came to meet Bin. When I interviewed Bin, what I saw in him was that he was smart, loved engineering, and was unusually happy. I hired him on the spot, and he fit right in. Did a good job, and was well-liked. When we finally met Bin's wife, Tom, well, the mystery of Bin's happiness was solved. Tom Lee was gorgeous, tall, with a perfect figure, and the baron of dynastic Chinese royalty. So that was what was behind Bin's ever-present smile. And we all agreed that his smile was well justified.
Hello, I am Tong Li. In China, I go out with handsome football player. My father told me to dump the football player and marry Bim. He say Bim is going somewhere. Football player is not. So I marry Bim. Bim is good husband, but very absent-minded. He always forget where he park car. He always forget to stop by supermarket on way home. He never remember where he put keys. In fact, he forgets almost everything. His mind always busy somewhere else. Maybe that is why he always looks confused. But that is why I love him so much.
One thing about life in America, I cannot figure out American speech. No matter what I try, it always comes out in Chinglish.
Never mind them. I am Bobo, the six-toed cat, and the center of the universe.
So, now that we have met our characters, we can begin our story.
One day at work, Ben told me that Tan Li was not happy with her life in the United States.
I am bored and lonely. Back hurt from no exercise. I homesick for family and friends back in China. I have no one to talk to during the day. I should have married football player and stay in China.
So I suggested to Ben that he find a larger apartment, see if he could find employment for Tan Li, and get her involved in some social activities in the local Chinese community.
Mike, right. Need nicer place to live than Connie. I find nice garden apartment in New Milford. We move. Things at home much better. Tom Lee like grass and trees and sunshine in garden apartment. Much better than Connie.
Okay, so now things are moving in the right direction. Ben was working out well, and his home life was much better.
Apartment nice, but I still lonely and homesick. I work hard to improve English so I can get car. I go back to school and get good job. Father right, football player going nowhere. Right thing, marry Bing.
But things at my home front were starting to get complicated. The fates turned on us sometime in September or October when we were greeted with a new arrival. A large, orange, six-toed cat greeted us when we arrived home after work one day. Apparently, he decided to adopt us. The problem was that we already had a cat, Morpheus, who, like all cats, ruled the roost. And Morpheus did not take kindly to this new arrival. Our first encounter with him was that look that cats give you when they expect service. Oh, you're home. It's about time. I was just getting hungry. Clearly, this cat knew who was in charge, and it wasn't us.
They kept me waiting. I expect to be fed around 6 o'clock or so, and now it was close to 7. I hope they have a good excuse.
With one look at the large, orange, six-toed cat, Morpheus puffed himself up and fled back in the house as if his tail was on fire. He was terrified. The orange cat, on the other hand, was completely unperturbed. As far as he was concerned, it was time for us to do our obeisance and feed him, and that's all there was to it.
A Siamese. Fancy boy.
All meow and no fight. Okay, folks, chop chop. It's dinner time. And none of that cheap dried stuff.
So we did our duty and gave him some food. Which was the worst thing we could possibly do. You might be able to pretend that you're not a cat servant, but cats can see right through this. And they know when they have you. And this large, orange, six-toed cat knew this in spades.
What people always choose to forget is that in ancient Egypt, where they understood things correctly, cats were recognized as gods and treated accordingly. Clearly, this failure is proof that humanity is on a downhill slide.
So, once we regained our senses, we decided that Morpheus had prior rights to be the one and only cat of the house, and the new guy just had to go. The problem was that our kids fell in love with the large, orange, six-toed cat and took to calling us cruel and heartless. Well, exercising the rule that might makes right, and we were still bigger than our kids then, we put the cat in the car and drove him about 10 blocks away. As we pushed him out of the car, we explained to him that we were in the best part of town and assured him that he would do just fine where we left him. We also explained that we were parting with no hard feelings and wished the best of luck in the future. We drove off feeling really good. We'd solved the problem at home and made a cat happy at the same time.
What jakes? Good luck. No hard feelings. Best part of town. Who do they think they are? I am a special cat. Look, I have six toes and they are my people. And that's the way it will be.
By the next afternoon, guess who's back at our front door? He signaled his magnanimity by indicating no ill will for our attempt to dump him, and that he was more than willing to let bygones be bygones and move on to some cat food. So after obliging him, we felt that the least we could do was compensate him for the discomfort of a 10-block walk. Back into the car he went. Only this time for a much longer distance. This time, though, when he left the car, he gave us that cat look that said everything.
I couldn't believe it! What knave! Who do they think they are? They did it again. I really have to think about letting it pass this time. I might even let them pet me when I get back home. These people have a lesson to learn.
As by now, I'm sure you've guessed, the large, orange, six-toed cat was back the very next afternoon. This time he looked quite so kindly toward us and just gave us some indignant looks. We're not even worthy of his scorn. Message sent, message received. He won, we caved. Morpheus would just have to learn to live with this new development. And in each life, a little rain must fall, and cats really hate rain. Unfortunately, Morpheus didn't see it this way. He was completely terrified and afraid to come home. So for 3 days, we just had one cat, and it was not Morpheus. It was the large, orange, six-toed cat. And then, it got worse. As the new king of the realm, this cat began to make his claim in a more noticeable way. He began to spread everywhere. That year, the fall was unusually damp, which really brings out the full flavor of cat spray. While lady cats may find this ode to cat irresistible, humans are repelled by it.
And now a word from our sponsor, Bell Cooking Products. Thanks for tuning in to the Bell Family Hour, brought to you by Bell Cooking Products.
Every little lady has a secret dream, things to make her house just gleam, things to make her meals the best. Bell's Cooking Products meet the test. In the kitchen, think the best.
Now that Valentine's Day is approaching, it's time for you to think of the little lady of the house. What can you get her to show her your love and appreciation for making your home your castle? This year, why not get her something that will remind her time and time again of all that you do for her? Why not get her something really special? Something new from the Bell Cooking Products catalog. The Bell's Cooking Products new improved turkey baster. Yes, This is the turkey baster that she's been dreaming about all year. The BCP 1000 turkey baster will change her life. Unlike old-fashioned turkey basters, the BCP 1000 turkey baster sprays, squirts, and dribbles like no other. Just squeeze the little red bulb and presto! No more, my side's too dark. Make her the envy of the neighborhood this Valentine's Day with the BCP 1000 turkey baster. Get one today before they're all gone. Now we return to our story. And so it began. The Smith household was in smoldering ruin. The kids had locked themselves in their rooms, were on a hunger strike, were placing calls to the Department of the Child Protection Services. The house stank of cat spray. Morpheus was nowhere to be found, and Mike's wife was eating Valium. All because of this damn six-toed orange cat. And this is where our story switches into high gear.
The next day, I went into work, did all the usual stuff. Answering calls, checking on the progress of work, staff meetings, all the usual stuff. But my mind was whirling. How do I solve this problem? Then it hit me like a thunderbolt. Morpheus's problem, my kid's problem, the six-toed orange cat's problem, Bin and Tong Lee's problem could all be solved in one master stroke. But, as with all brilliant solutions, one must proceed cautiously and carefully lay the groundwork. And that is what I did.
And so the plan took root and began to grow.
The next morning, I started a conversation with Bin, and I asked him how Tong Lee was doing in the new apartment. He told me what I already knew, that although the apartment was very nice, Tong Lee was still unhappy and lonely, and he had no idea how to make her happy. And that was my cue to strike. I said to Bin, I know exactly how to make her happy.
How you know that?
As any con artist will tell you, that look of relief on the Mark's face is priceless. Particularly when you add in Bin's perfect Chinglish and look of complete bewilderment. Now, as any master manipulator knows, you slowly dole out the story. You feed the Mark succulent little pieces, which they cannot help but bite on. And with each successive bite, you draw them further into the web you have created. And so, that is what I did with Bin. Bin, you know, I've been married a long time, and my marriage has been a good one. It's been a good one because I've learned over the years how to make my wife happy.
Yes, I know that, but how I make Tong Lee happy?
Bin, I said that in my most serious voice. You have to give her what she wants most.
And what does Tong Lee want most?
Okay, the hook was nearly all the way in now, and all I had to do was just tug a little to plant it firmly in his mouth and reel him in without any chance of him slipping away. Bin, how long have you been married to Tong Lee?
Almost 2 years, and we're very happy. But what does she want?
Bin, think about it. What does any woman want after 2 years of marriage? What does a woman who is lonely and missing her family want? What is it that all women want to satisfy their innermost needs?
Jewelry?
No, Bin, not jewelry. Something far more important than jewelry. Think about it.
New clothing!
No, Bin, something more important than clothing. Something she needs to fulfill her innermost needs.
Uh-huh. shoes.
No, Ben, not shoes. What Tan Li needs and wants most is a baby. She would be happy if she had a baby.
A baby? Are we not ready for baby? I have work. I go school for PhD. Tong Li has to study and learn English so she can work and we can buy house. Oh, we cannot have baby at this time. That is impossible.
Bin? I said so innocently. Bin, you know, I didn't think of that. You're right. Now is not the time for you to have a baby. But still, a baby is what you need to fix your problem. Oh, sometimes I am so bad. So really bad.
Oh, this is terrible. I think you're right, baby, make Tong Li happy, but this is something we cannot do. There must be another way.
Bin! I said with the feigned astonishment of a Tony Award-winning actor. Bin! I just had a thought. Do you know what the next best thing to having a baby is?
No. What is next best thing to a baby?
A cat. Bin, a cat. A cat is the next best thing to having a baby. Cats are cute and cuddly and will not interfere with Tong Li studying English or even going to work.
Mike, I think you're right. And I know Tong Li liked cat because she had cat in China. Yes, cat would make Tong Li very happy. But where do I get cat?
Bing, you are in luck. I just happen to have an extra cat. In fact, I have a very special cat, a lucky cat, a cat with six toes, and he is orange.
An orange cat? An orange cat! Orange is Tong Li's favorite color! On six toes? I never hear of cat with six toes. Orange cat with six toes. And you can give me cat?
Now, so close to fulfilling my diabolical plan, I say, right, but before you do anything, you best ask Tong Li if she'd want a cat. Always keep the sucker wanting.
Ask me if I want cat. I really want baby. But this is impossible. So, cat, next best thing. An orange cat with six toes, even better. Orange, my favorite color. And grandfather told me that a cat with six toes will bring good luck and good fortune into our lives.
The next day, Bin comes into work with the biggest smile anyone has ever seen on his face.
Well, I knew my plan was working perfectly. So I said to Bin, I will bring the cat into work tomorrow, but there is one small thing I forgot to mention. The cat is a boy and has to be fixed.
Fixed? Cat broken?
No, Bin, there is nothing broken on the cat. It's just a way of saying that the cat needs to be neutered so that he doesn't spray all over your house. If he sprays, it will stink up your house terribly.
Oh, I see. I asked Tong Li if she wants cat fixed. Tong Li, Mike say cat has to be fixed. Nothing broken, but cat will spray and make house stink.
No, I have cat in China and not fix and not stink up house. I want cat as is.
And so the next day, Bin looked upset. Bin, what's wrong? Doesn't Tong Li want the cat anymore?
No, Tong Li still want cat, but not want cat fixed. She say she want him as is. She say her cat in China not fixed and was okay.
Bin, if that is what Tong Li wants, that is okay with me. But let me warn you again. A mature male cat will spray all over your house and the smell will be terrible.
That evening, Bin goes to Mike's house to collect the six-toed orange cat. This Smith family does a major happy dance in the streets as they celebrate their good luck. Everyone wins on this, including both cats. And that was supposed to be the end of the story. But again, this is where the fates intervened, and the story of Ben and the six-toed orange cat starts to move into yet a higher gear. 2 days later, Ben comes into work looking very worried.
What's wrong, Ben? Is the cat working out okay? Does Tonley like the cat?
I like cat very much. Name cat Bobo, which means baby in Chinese. I like cats so much, but cat spray all over house, and the house stinks very bad now. I tell Ben he should not have brought home cat that spray, and I want cat fixed. Now! I knew I should have married football player and stayed in China.
Okay, Ben, that is no big deal. I can help you with that. There is a good vet in Teaneck that can do the job. Just bring the cat in tomorrow, and I will make the arrangements. No problem.
Oh, that's good. I tell Tongli, and she be very happy have cat fixed and not stink up house.
The next day, I come into work and see everyone standing in front of the building, and all the windows are open. What's going on? Is there a fire?
What happened was that Ben came to work with Bobo and brought him into the building where Bobo went around spraying and stunk up the entire building. Because of the smell, everyone had to evacuate the building. There was Ben, our PhD candidate, with a pail and a mop trying to clean up the stink made by Bobo.
I am sorry. Cut spray in house, cut spray in car, cut spray in building, cut spray really stink. Cut has to get fixed.
Okay, we can deal with this. Just take the cat to the vet and that will be that. The vet is 15 minutes away and here are the directions.
With directions in hand, Ben leaves with Bobo to go to the vet. Now anyone would have thought that would have been the end of it. But no. An hour goes by. Then two. Then three. So what happened to Ben and the six-toed orange cat?
Just as I was about to call him, Ben pulls up in front of the building looking very, very sad. Ben! You've been gone almost 3 hours. The vet is just 15 minutes away. What happened?
Oh, very bad thing happened. I go to bring cat to vet. Car smell very bad, so I open windows to let stink out. I stop at traffic light, and cat jump out of car.
Yes!
I look cat for all over, but cat is gone. Bobo is gone, and Tong Li will be very mad at me.
Now, this was completely unexpected. Well, not completely. Remember, Ben is the absent-minded professor.
Okay, Ben, tell me where you lost the cat and we will go find him.
No, that is problem. I not know.
What? You don't know where you were when the cat jumped out of the car.
Cats smell so bad and cat jumping all over car that I get lost and not know where cat jump out of car.
Now I really started to get worried. My plane was disintegrating right before my eyes. Okay, Ben, think hard. Let's drive around and see if you remember anything about where you were when the cat jumped out of the car.
So around and around they drove, trying every street that one might take to get to the vet's office. Ben would say, I think I see that building, or, well, that building looked familiar, or I think I passed that street. After about an hour or so, Ben says,
Ah! I remember seeing boat!
Boat? How do you get from our office to Teaneck and see boats? Then it hit me. Instead of leaving the building and turning left, as per my instructions, Bing must have turned right and went in the opposite direction, past the Hackensack River, where there are boats. Okay, I think I know where you might have been. Bin.
So off they go where boats are, and sure enough, Bin says,
I lost my peach. Yes! This is where cuts your bottle car. At least they think this is where cuts your bottle car.
We get out of the car and go up and down the streets, looking under parked cars, behind houses, all the while making catcalls. Anyway, search as we might, we could not find Bobo. I suggested to Ben that we go back to the office, print up a bunch of missing cat signs, and post them in that neighborhood. I was sure we had little hope of ever seeing the cat return, but I felt it was the least I could do. Ben was really worried about how he was going to tell this to Tom Lee.
The missing cat signs were printed and posted where the cat went missing. The next day, Ben arrived at work looking terrible. His clothes were rumpled, and his eyes were red and puffy.
What's wrong, Ben?
Oh, totally very mad I lose cat. She locked me out of house. I sleep in car.
Ben, lose cat I love. Now I am sure I should have married football player and stay in China.
Wow. Talk about a woman's scorn. Because he lost the cat, Ben was in the doghouse. But that's how it was, and that's how anyone would expect it to be until it all blew over. But again, the fates.
You won't believe this, but 2 days later, and around 11 o'clock at night, I get a phone call from Ben.
Cat is back! I have Bobo again! Tong Li let me back in house.
Ben, what are you talking about?
Oh, Bobo very smart. He find Grey House on Chestnut Street. We live in Grey House on Chestnut Street.
Ben, very smart to pick such smart cat. Father right, football player going nowhere. Right thing, Mary Ben.
Ben, you live three towns away. What are you talking about?
Oh, right. That is why Bobo's so smart. Even though he in different town, he still know Grey House and Chestnut Street. He sit on steps of Grey House and Chestnut Street until a person who live there let him in. Person who live there see missing cat poster and call me. He say cat very nice, but not want him anymore. Cat spray up his house and he want him gone. So he call me. I get in car and go to his house. Pick up cat. Tong Li is very happy now. Can you help me get cat to bed tomorrow?
Well, needless to say, I was astounded. Bobo is back. Ben is happy. Tong Li is happy. And I am happy. All that has to happen now is to get Bobo fixed, and the story will have a happy ending. Or so we thought. The next day, I pull up in front of the building, and once again, everyone is clustered, standing outside around Ben's car. Oh, no. Not another stink evacuation. Where is that damn cat and where is Ben?
I not want to lose cat again. So I'm very careful to keep cat inside car with windows closed. But I lock keys inside of car. Everyone come out to help open car.
And sure enough, inside the car were the keys and Bobo, looking like he was getting ready to give the car another blast of cat spray.
Well, we are coming to the end of the story of Ben and the six-toed orange cat. They eventually got the car door open.
And so, I gave Ben written instructions to the vet, made him promise not to open any windows in the car until the cat was with the vet, and 45 minutes later, Ben was back from the vet without the cat.
Next day, I bring fixed cat home, and Tong Li very happy. Because of Kat, we wait 2 years for Tong Li to learn English, get new job, buy a nice house in Emerson, and then have children. Everyone happy now.
The end of the story is that Bobo lived on to a ripe old age at the Zhu house, where he continued to rule the roost in regal manner. Tong Li would feed Bobo fresh shrimp, not from a bowl, but at the dining room table along with the rest of the family. Bobo would walk up the middle of the street on his nightly patrols and visit most of the homes in the neighborhood, where everyone knew him as Bobo, the large orange six-toed cat. When Bobo finally left this earth, his passing was marked by tears from the Zhu family, my family, and much of the neighborhood.
Oh yes, Father was right. Football player, not good choice. Bin, much better.
And that is the end of the story of Bin and the six-toed orange cat. And would you believe it, every word of this story is true. And thanks for tuning in to the Bell Family Hour, brought to you by Bell's Cooking Products.
Cats, they're the sweetest cats. They're the meanest cats. Just the way it goes. Meow, 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 cats. They're the cutest cats. They're the rudest cats. We are the way to know. Just the way it goes.